The anniversary season of the AFL continues, and we've got the originals. They played the first game ever in AFL history, the Patriots and the Broncos, here in the Mile High City. Denver undefeated at 4-0, while New England is 3-1. Hello, friends. Jim Nantz, along with Phil Simms. So many interesting things to talk about, but let's begin with the obvious here. Bill Belichick against the pupil now, Josh McDaniels. What do you expect we'll see here today, Phil?
Well, we know, just from talking to both of them, they know a lot about the other team, of course. What I'm anxious to see, which coach comes up with some new ideas that catches his former boss off balance and gives him big plays and maybe give him a chance to win.
Well, Phil, I'll say this. It's cold. It's the coldest game of this young season by about 20 degrees. It's below freezing. And the wind chill right around 20. There was snow here in Denver yesterday. This game brought to you in high definition here on CBS. Good to have all of you with us. So, again, celebrating this 50-year anniversary of the AFL's first season. They're all decked out now in the throwback uniforms. You may not recognize the Broncos in their seal brown and mustard gold uniforms. And it's going to be a touchback to begin. Now, New England won the toss and elected to kick it away. So we'll see Kyle Orton and company begin at the 20. What a flawless start to the season it has been for Kyle Orton. Only starting quarterback in the league who has not thrown a pick this season. 5 touchdowns, no interceptions. Mistake-free. And one of the many reasons why this Broncos bunch has been a big early season surprise at 4-0. Orton already lining up wide to the left as the Broncos come out with a surprise formation. Moreno, the rookie running back, takes the direct snap, and he stiff-arms a couple and gets out for a gain of 12 yards. This is something they just put in the program this week at practice.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. Watch him practice. It's called Wild Horses here in Denver, and the Patriots look like they had a chance to make the tackle for no gain. But missed tackles, kind of reminiscent of what they did against the Miami Dolphins last year when they saw this for the first time.
Now Orton comes out of the slot and directly back under center. This Wild Horses formation on the first 2 snaps. Orton, though, throws it, and that's pulled down by Brandon Marshall, wrapped up quickly by Bodden. So you got Orton coming over in the trade from Chicago. His line that he now plays behind is the exact 5 from a year ago. And Clady still has not allowed a sack in his second year, former first-round pick out of Boise State. And Moreno, the only rookie in the league who has already rushed for a touchdown and caught a touchdown.
Jim, we talked about new wrinkles. What do you think Bill Belichick's thinking? Oh, my gosh, he brought that out on us.
Second down and 9. And a good play-action fake, and the pass coming over to Marshall. His second grab breaks a couple of New England attempts, just as he did against the Cowboys late last week to win it. That goes for 13 yards.
Well, Brandon Marshall, his nickname is the Beast for a reason here in Denver, because he's so big and strong. We saw it last year, a couple years, with Jay Cutler as the quarterback. But once he catches the football, this is when he's dangerous. Won the game for him last week against the Dallas Cowboys. Strong enough to break the tackles. Fast enough to get big plays.
Orton shifts over to the right side, back to the Wild Horses formation. Moreno plows ahead for a quick 5. Now, you remember this Patriots defense was the first one that had to go against the Wildcat formation at about this same time, early October last year against Miami. They're going with 4 up front, including Mike Wright, who had a couple of sacks last week. They do have Mayo active today. He's back much sooner than expected. Guyton, second-year man, free agent out of Georgia Tech, who's been quite a development in this defense for New England. Merriweather and others in that secondary trying to slow down the Broncos on this opening possession. Sanders, by the way, is out today, out with a shoulder, inactive. Orton completes it to Scheffler, who hurdles for a couple more. They're down to the New England 35-yard line. He hopped right over Lee Bodden, goes for 14.
Well, this shifting, this formation, what it's doing, it makes the New England Patriots simplify what they're doing on the defensive side. In the NFL, anytime you get a quarterback and he knows what he's going to get in pass coverage, especially when it's something that's simple and routine, they are going to complete the passes.
So Orton wide to the left, direct snap again, Moreno, and it goes for another quick 5-yard clip. Now, one of the reasons in talking to Josh McDaniels on Friday, they wanted to go to this attack. And again, they just implemented it in practice this week, was to try to simplify what the defense is showing them.
It makes the defense settle down. You've heard me say, when you make defensive players think, what does it do to them? It makes them less aggressive. It makes them a half a step slower. And that's all you need on the offensive side.
Timeout, New England. Patriots want to come over and talk about what they're seeing, what they're going against here on this opening drive. Coach Belichick, Bill had about 90 seconds to try to tell his team how to adjust to this wild horse's attack.
Yeah, I know. I wonder what he's thinking going, I can't believe Josh McDaniels went to this offense.
What's he doing? I can't believe it. Here they go again with Moreno, and they do adjust. And that's the first time they've slowed it down.
That's right, Jim, but this offense makes so much sense because the difference in this, in the so-called wildcat that a lot of people run, is they're giving the quarterback that option to come in motion and get under the center, and he's seeing the same coverages that the running back would see. That's what makes this different, and in my opinion, a lot smarter.
Well, this time it's going to be Orton out of the shotgun on third down and 6. Well, sealed the pocket and the pass incomplete. It was intended for Brandon Stokely, and McGowan helped break it up. McGowan in there today for Sanders as he was a week ago.
Yeah, inside, watch Stokely as he comes across the middle. This is something the New England Patriots see every single day when they practice. So McGowan knew it, stood his ground, and waited for the receiver to break back out, and he was all over the pass.
Former Patriot long snapper Lonnie Paxton will send it back to Brett Kern, and Matt Prater will try it from 48 yards. He's 8 of 10 on the season. Got a big leg, big success outside of 50. Prater's kick, not this time. Wide right. Patriots will have the football at the 38. They'll have it for the first time. The Skycam view is presented by Astro Boy, the movie. We're going to see the Patriots coming out again in their throwback uniforms.
Like them.
Brady, who has had trouble in his career against Denver, comes to the line at the 38 to begin things. The Patriots at 3-1 off a victory against Baltimore last week. It's Sammy Morris getting the start as Taylor is out today, dinged with an ankle. That's a gain of 6. Brady in his career, playoffs and regular season, 1 win in 6 starts against Denver. His only losing record against any opponent, and it's 1-5 against Denver. So a 6-yard run by Morris. They send Kevin Falk back to the left side. Another running play, and Morris grabbed by the ankle. Stepping up and making the hit is Jack Williams, second-year man out of Kent State. That line up front, a familiar sight for New England with Matt Light, the man out of Purdue, same school that delivered Kyle Orton. Mankins, Copen, Neal, and Kazier. We'll be seeing a lot of shuttling around, but not only Morris, but Maroney. Falk's already seen action as well, but again, Taylor is out. And it's a 3rd and 4 coming up for the Pats. Julian Edelman has come in as an extra receiver. Brady, he's got the time to stand still, and he hits Edelman, who has the first. There's another rookie and another player out of Kent State. 7th-round pick, picks up 6 and a first.
First off, Tom Brady. A defense that moves around a lot. Look at all the guys standing. The protection is very good, but you got Julian Edelman, and on the other side, you got Wes Welker crossing, makes it hard. Look at the Matt Light on the outside, Elvis Dumerville. Matt Light has come up big this year against some good pass rushers.
On first down, they fake the reverse. Looking screen, it's Morris. Blockers in front, clear it. Morris inside the 30. And inside the 20 and fouls ahead to the 15. running behind Mankins and Copen. Boy, did they open up that side. Goes for 35.
Looked like the opening play of the Super Bowl a couple years ago, except this time they hit it. Fake the reverse. You got everybody moving to the opposite side where the screen is going to be. Mankins, you're right, Jim. Offensive linemen on screens. If you hit the ground, you're going to make defensive players at least slow down and jump over you. That creates the running lane for Morris.
From the 15, Morris, maybe a yard. Doomerville and others, this Denver defense that's been impenetrable so far on the season, allowing only 26 points, including Peterson, who played for Josh McDaniels' father back in high school in Canton, Ohio. Doomerville, 8 sacks already on the season. That's tied for most in the league. 8 new starters on this Denver defense from a year ago. First in the league, fewest points allowed. Second, fewest yards allowed. But they've got New England moving it on them right away. Second out of 9. Morris slashes. And he's stuck then at the 9. Chris Baker helped open up that right side for 6.
You know, as I watch these plays, New England with their array of formations and personnel. That time, the whole Denver defense, they were all standing, looking at each other, making signs. They are a defense. They change according to what you do. They change plays, who's going to cover who, depending on your personnel. Very complicated, but they've made it work so far this year.
Giving up only 2 touchdowns has the Denver defense through 4 games, including no touchdown passes on the season. It's a 3rd and 3, and Brady looking in zone, slashing in. That is a touchdown to Welker. That's the first touchdown pass allowed by the Denver defense, and it is Wes Welker from 8 yards out.
It would take a combination like Brady to Welker to do it, too. To your right, watch Welker come in and make all these moves. It's in, it's out, and then he comes back inside. Woodyard, how can you cover something like that? Pass protection excellent. Tom Brady steps up in the pocket and makes it happen.
Gostkowski out to add the extra point. Impressive start for the New England offense. 7-0. So Denver misses a field goal, gives the Patriots a shorter field. Morris on a big screen. Welker on the touchdown catch. 7-0. Patriots. Here in Denver, where it's Throwback Sunday. 2 of the original 8 members of the AFL, the 2 teams that played in the first regular season game ever in the American Football League on a Friday, September the 9th, 1960, at Boston University Field, and Denver won it out there 13-10 on a long punt return by Gene Mingo, who was here for the coin toss today, and Gino Cappelletti, who was on the other side for the Patriots, participating in that. And in fact, if you look at the New England release put together by Stacey James and his great team, it's all about Boston, not New England. Boston travels to Denver on Sunday, it says. And for 4 games this year, they're going to, as legacy games, compete as the Boston Patriots. We're going to call them New England anyway.
Okay, I don't want to confuse anybody, so let's do that.
Here's McKinley. Kenny McKinley does not get it out to the 20. Those uniforms that the Broncos are wearing, they wore them their first 2 years. Coming back out, down 7-0. Kyle Orton. Kansas City remains winless. Thank you, JB. Miles Austin. Here's the play with Marino. Marino breaks the tackle, and he's got a first down out at the 35-yard line. Burst free for 12.
Couple times they've had the point of attack. The New England Patriots, they stop it. But somebody's got to put their arms around Sean Marino. Good job of staying alive, keeping his vision, and breaking outside to get a first down.
Karell Buckhalter, their leading rusher, inactive today, just like Taylor on the other side, also out with an ankle. That's now the 4th play already for the Broncos, and for at least 10 yards. Horton dumps it, and Moreno fumbled it on the back end. He thought he was down. He's pointing down, but the officials still haven't agreed with that. He was hit by Mayo.
I didn't hear a whistle, and even if you did, this still would be reviewable. So New England needs to look.
Feels that the ball was fumbled, recovered by the defense. First down, New England.
Recovered by McGowan, so that's the ruling on the field that the Patriots have recovered, and McDaniels is going to want a little idea from upstairs.
Yeah, does he get down before he fumbles? Nope, the ball comes out. It is loose. And you notice it more and more of NFL officials, they let the play go longer. And even though they did this time, it was a fumble.
How about the guy that's putting the hit on him here, Mayo, who's back after only missing little action. He was supposed to be out for a month and a half. Was out last week.
Big and fast. When you're big and fast, you hit somebody carrying the football, sometimes it's going to come loose.
Boy, Josh McDaniels is looking up at the big screen here, and he's really wondering, do I want to go waste a timeout and issue a challenge that he probably won't win? He's going to go ahead and have him review it.
Well, it's such a big play. If there's any doubt, first half of the game, you challenge it.
What do you think?
It's definitely a fumble.
Yep.
And you know me, I like the waffle. But this one I'm really sure of.
Denver's challenging the ruling on the field that the ball was fumbled. We'll review the play.
Well, Checkers is now going to go press his face up against a television monitor under the curtain. We'll take a break. They're reviewing a Moreno fumble, which will be his second lost fumble in the last two games if it holds up the ruling on the field. Hit by Mayo.
Football's loose. He never regains possession of it. It moves around on the ground. New England football. How about that? Mayo, like you said, Jim, back a lot faster than everybody expected from that injury.
Yep.
Causing that fumble.
By the way, do not forget your red flag if you're on the sideline. Okay? That's one thing that's crucial. You got to come to work with all your full toolkit. Look at Coach Belichick a moment ago. Our guys caught this. Hey, go get me the red flag.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. The runner lost control of the ball prior to going down to the ground. It was recovered by the defense at the 43-yard line. Denver will be charged with their first time out.
Well, the only thing, and I know McDaniels had seen it up on the big board and thought it was very unlikely he'd win it, but if there's anything it did do in terms of taking the challenges, it gave his defense a little bit more rest. They had just given up a long drive and had not been sitting off on the sideline for too long.
It's really a very good point. That and the fact that it's in the first half, so the timeout is not quite as valuable to you in the first half as it would be in the second half.
From the 43, Morris. Oh, a nice couple of cuts. Goes for 10, running behind Chris Baker. Here's a Phil philosophy.
Well, the first couple weeks, Tom Brady, we saw he was missing receivers. But here, Wes Welker, no matter what he does, he's always looking down the field. And if he ever gets in trouble, what does he do? He looks for Wes Welker. That's what the Broncos talked about all week. He looks at two or three receivers, then he's going to try to find Wes Welker short.
Get three tight ends in for New England. That run by Morris was good enough for a first. We're going to run it again. This time a good stick. Coming up and making the play first was Brian Dawkins. Came over from Philadelphia in the offseason as a free agent after 13 years with the Eagles.
You see the three tight ends, one, two, and three. And the Patriots call this the load formation. It's a big, heavy load when you get all three of them in there. It settles the defense down, but it makes them more aggressive against the run.
It lost 2 yards for New England. Second down and 12. Back over to Walker, and it's knocked down. That's Jack Williams making a play. Second time his name's been called.
Well, Jack Williams made some big plays against the Dallas Cowboys last week. And you're right, twice so far today, though, Jim, but nice breakup. And again, all week long, or on Friday when we watched him practice, Josh McDaniels kept saying, telling the defense who to look at in certain formations and situations of the New England offense.
It's a third and 12 from the Denver 35. Brady steps up, launches it long, wide open, and over the head of Moss. Been waiting this season to see these two hook up on a long one, and they had a chance right here.
It's a blitz, and it's really well designed. They get both receivers going up the field, and when the first one breaks out, Goodman goes for it, and Tom Brady knows it doesn't come much easier than that throw to Randy Moss.
You said he was overthrowing in the first couple of weeks. Last week he was on target, you felt, more than any other game so far. But that's one he'd love to have back. Gostkowski, this will be from 53 yards. Gostkowski's kick, it's a beauty, and it's good. That's a career-long kick for Gostkowski here in the mile-high air of Denver. 10-0 New England, first quarter.
Okay.
You can watch Fantasy Football Today to get the last-minute news and analysis you need for your Fantasy League lineup. It's live every Sunday, 11 a.m. Eastern, only on CBSSports.com. Well, it was 10-0 early last week in the first quarter, in fact. Dallas over Denver, and then the Broncos shut them out the rest of the way, pick up their fourth consecutive victory.
Yeah, the difference here is, Jim, some good runs by the Patriots offense, and they got a receiver open, wide open down the field. Dallas did not do that.
They're close, coach.
Gostkowski will drive this one deep. And it's a touchback for the second time off his leg here in the first quarter. But it could have been more than three on that last possession for the Patriots.
Oh, yeah. Just look at the defense, how it's up top. And it's two on two with the whole field down at the bottom against Randy Moss. And the fact that they stacked those two receivers, the Broncos either were in the wrong coverage or they got to rethink what they're going to do against certain formations. Because they were definitely outman and outthought on that last play.
So Ty Warren digging in. There's the throw to the sideline. Over to Eddie Royal. Only his ninth catch of the season after a 90-plus catch season as a rookie last year. Goes for eight.
Broncos so far this year have been very good in their short passing game. And that means quick throws to the receivers to the outside, and their screen game has been exceptional.
Tony Scheffler back in. He had been dinged up on that hurdling attempt after a catch, and that's no gain that time for Moreno. You know, there's been a lot of confusion exactly what is his last name, Moreno, like our man back in the studio. But he tried to clear it up with us on Friday. It's Moreno. And the rookie is outstanding. No Sean, by the way. A little conjunct, if you will, of his parents' two names. His father was actually nicknamed Knowledge. That's where the K-N-O-W comes. And his mother's name is LaShawn. That's how they came up with No Sean. See what the Denver offense can do here. They'll take a Denver offense calling a timeout on third and short.
Lined up in the wrong formation. Kyle Orton has to call a timeout.
I don't see that doesn't happen more often with all this shifting around they're doing. Just a few days to prepare for it, you know. Tonight, Amazing Race. Will it be the end of the race for one team when they lose their passports? It's an all-new Amazing Race tonight after 60 Minutes on America's Most Watched Network.
Let me answer your question. Did you watch practice on Friday? They went for like 6 hours?
You were shocked how long that practice went.
It went forever. And that's why they do so many things. They got so many formations, so many plays. So they just stay out there and they just keep going over everything, situations, you know, third down, whatever, 2 minutes. And so they won't have mistakes like this on the field, Jim. Cost them a timeout.
Boy, the Patriots got caught in a shift at the last second out of that timeout. And they have to call a time. Denver's down the one. Remember, they used the one on the lost challenge, and Just a minute ago, another one. So each team has one timeout remaining here in the opening half.
A little gamesmanship going on here. Like every game, it's not just because these Bill Belichick and Josh McDaniels work together. If the Broncos do get a first down here, I wouldn't be surprised, this is just me guessing, that they will come back out in the Wild Horses offense and try to look to get a big play down the field in the passing game.
Here the New England defense running out, others running on. And they had to resort to the time.
Somebody's going to get yelled at because one coach's job is just to say what personnel is on the field so they can make the adjustments down on the field.
Shotgun snap coming to Orton. Needs to get to the 30 for the first. That's the middle. And the forward progress, what will they give him? Doesn't look like it's quite enough. Marshall, let's see. The linesman on the near side, a little more generous than the far side.
Here you go. The nose of that football is a half inch short of that white stripe. It's going to be fourth down.
Marshall trying to get a move on Mayo, backed up a little bit. They didn't even measure it. It's fourth and inches to go.
Well, that would be one of those, Jim. If they did give him the first down, that's when Bill Belichick should have challenged him.
They knew they had to go ahead and touch the line there after the touchback. Edelman back to receive the punt from Brett Kern, who last week punted six times against the Cowboys and averaged 51 yards a punt. Snags a little bit of a wayward snap. Kills it back inside the 10. Edelman shifting past one hit and out to the 23. 64 yards on the punt, 17-yard return. All right, this Denver defense has been so hot. Well, not so far today, but tell us what they've been doing right this season.
You know, Jim, what's really helped them, besides all the new players and their talent, is all the moving around. It's just about confusion. And so far this year, four games, it's worked very well. But New England has just come out, and how you settle any defense down the NFL, if you come out and run the football, that's going to stop some of the movement, because now you got to get ready, brace yourself, and fight the guy in front of you man-to-man.
They empty out the backfield with Falk to the top. Aiken and Edelman are in as extra receivers. On first down, again, Brady, excellent time, and it's Edelman. And he is somersaulted down after a gain of six. Boy, do they spread out the field and they give the quarterback protection.
Well, they do. And, you know, Tom Brady, veteran quarterback, he knows right away. He sees that it's going to be three down linemen. Right away, it goes off in your brain. You go, I can take my time. Because the initial coverage was outstanding, but because it was so long, Edelman comes wide open.
A second down and four up the middle. And falling within a yard of the first is Morris, third and one.
You know, I didn't really learn that in my career, but now coaches coach it so much about the three-man rush. Dan Reeves always used to say to me, when you see three guys rushing you, don't be in a hurry because you got extra time and you can move around more as a quarterback. And I used to go, no, I don't think so, you know, because had been taught that, but wasn't ingrained into me. But now all quarterbacks are very aware of those situations.
Sack specialist Dumerville out. They stack the line here, third and less than a yard. Patriots, quick early hit. Morris, boy, he fought hard, but he's going to be a little short. He could have been dropped for about a three-yard loss. Davis was in on him quickly, Andre Davis, but no gain and fourth down coming up.
Andre Davis, number 54, and DJ Williams, number 55. Both of them, Davis makes the runner change his path, and DJ Williams gets in there on the tackle.
Chris Hansen out to punt.
Two big middle inside linebackers who have played very well against the run this year.
Hansen had the fewest punts returned by percentage last year in the league. Only 22% of his punts were returnable. Sends it high, and it's going to be run back this time. Eddie Royal. And the ball's out, picked up by Denver. And out to the 37, that's Jack Williams. Again, this second-year DB out of Kent State, a fourth-round pick last year, and heads-up play. After a 49-yard punt, 12-yard return, had another 6 yards on the fumble recovery run.
Gosh, it's coming to the football. And I said it earlier in the game, the officials over the last couple years, they let the guys play longer. Finish the play before you blow the whistle. And what does that mean? That just means more guys can get in on the tackle, and then that extra guy, the second and third man that comes in there, they can try to rip the football out.
7 seconds to go in the first quarter. Good starting point for Denver. Orton completes it. Jabbar Gaffney. And the Broncos will begin the second quarter in New England territory after a gain of 18. Through one, New England 10, Denver nothing. We'll return to Denver after these messages. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Gaffney takes it down to the 43. Even the Denver PR staff is in throwback uniforms. Dave Galen, the understudy to the legendary Jim Sacamano of the media relations here in Denver, got the press pass attached to the side of the fedora. We're going to begin the second quarter here. Jim Nantz, Phil Sims with Denver. First down from the New England 43. Moreno for no game.
Vince Wilfork, number 75, inside. You know, if you look at the stat sheet, doesn't make a lot of tackles, but he just ruins a lot of running plays. Comes across, just runs Ben Hamilton back in the backfield. Moreno actually runs into his guard, Ben Hamilton. That's a big man.
Moreno may have been a little dinged on that last play. Here on second down, Orton. Back over to Gaffney. It'll be third and about six coming up.
You know, Bill Belichick, what did he tell us last week? And you talk about Vince Wilfork, Ty Warren, Jarvis Green, even Mike Wright. Just said, look, nobody just gashes us with the run because they are built to do that. You know, if you get 5 yards, let me tell you, that's quite an accomplishment against this New England defense when it comes to running the football.
Lamont Jordan, another former Patriot on this Bronco roster, in. Moreno out. Need to get to the 34 for the first. Third down. Orton. On and out of the hands of Scheffler. That was McGowan who broke that one up.
Yeah, McGowan, we've said his name twice. Good job. And just to show you New England, they double team an old teammate of theirs, Jabbar Gaffney. But it happened just a little too quick where Scheffler's not able to create any separation from McGowan.
So they'll bring out Brett Kern to punt. Kevin Falk retreats back inside the 10. Kern gets the bounce that he didn't want. Hops right into the end zone, netting only 20 yards. 10-0. Patriots will have it at the 20. Minute and a half into the second quarter, leading at 10-0. They begin at the 20 and out of the gun. Brady over to Welker for six.
Jim, we talked about, let's take a look at the spotlight, CBS iVision. What's the offensive lineman of the Patriots outside? Here we got Mankins, and then watch the center, Dan Copen, how far he gets down the field on the screen play and leads so they can get those extra yards once they catch a short pass.
That 35-yard play to Morris set up the touchdown pass to Welker on second and four. It's Edelman sidestepping a hit. He's about a yard shy of the first. He's trying to pick up extra yards and probably could have easily had the first.
Julian Edelman is not Wes Welker. but he's not real far behind it either.
Well, and he's a former quarterback.
Yeah, well, he understands how to get in space, what to do, what the quarterback's looking for. But now when you put them both on the field, you have one on each side, who's going to run the route that gives them all those options? Very clever by the Patriots.
Third and a yard. Maroney. Just enough for the first. And that's his first carry, and it's enough to move the sticks.
Well, he wants another carry. He knew in a situation like this, it, when in doubt, just try to run somebody over. That is a good run by Lawrence Maroney.
And Ryan McBean on his back. Picked up a little more than a yard and a new set of downs. He earns that other handle. Makes good use of it. Maroney for 10. Logan Mankins, watch number 70. Help open up things right in the middle of the field.
Yeah, Patriots a little bit old school. You know, it's not all zone blocking where you just kind of all go off at one level. Mankins comes around, showing that he's versatile, gets a good kick out. The run is a little delayed to the left. It comes back to the right, so he catches the defense off guard just enough to give him a first down.
And Copen also showing his Pro Bowl form on that block for another first. Morris. This time things are clogged. Picks up three, maybe four. What is the most dangerous sport in the world? How about jumping off a cliff and flying like a bird? You'll see it tonight on 60 Minutes, only on CBS. This wouldn't be too far behind that, though. Hard-hitting action like we're seeing here in Denver.
I'd definitely take my chances on the football field.
Instead of flying off a cliff? I'd like to see you do that. Second and seven. Welker shakes free. Welker, there's a flag down. He's to the 41 of Denver.
It's going to be, are there 12 defenders on the field for the Denver Broncos?
Boy, Champ Bailey is just certain that it's going to be against New England. Pointing and pointing, but Moss pointing the other way.
Defense, 12 men. That penalty's declined. Result of the play, first down.
I didn't know you could count to 12 that fast.
Wow, that's just not nice. I'm a quick counter. Let's just try to do it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How about that, Jim?
And that's illegal? How long have they been getting away with that?
No, they're not saying count to 12.
Goes for 15, and Brady almost lost the football and wisely throws it out. For a minute, it was kind of bobbling around in his arms.
Blitz, Davis. Gets right through, gets past the running back. Good timing right there. Oh, Lawrence Maroney made a big mistake. He went down to try to cut him, and the linebackers, they're getting so good at that. They see these running backs, and they just try to hit them at the knees. They hesitate, go right around them, all over Tom Brady.
It's a second and 10 for Brady. Operating from the Denver 41. Pump fake, second time throws it, and that's incomplete. All right, maybe they give him the catch. They're going to give him the catch. Chris Baker, that almost looked like it was a pick opportunity. Gain of three.
I know one thing, they're making Tom Brady throw the football in some tight windows. That's going to be incomplete if they want to challenge it, but it's only a yard or two. So it's not worth a challenge, I don't think, by Josh McDaniels.
Yeah, they officially give him 3 yards, but Denver's going to let it go. Are they?
No.
They've thrown the challenge flag. They're going to try to recover the 3 yards.
Me, I would have saved it. 3 yards in this situation, I definitely would have saved it.
Denver is challenging the ruling on the field that the pass is complete. We will review the play. Timeout.
Denver has only one timeout remaining in the half. Daniels wants them to look at it, trying to slow down the New England Express. It's kind of an oddity. Here we are in the second quarter. There's been one flag in the game, and it was picked up. But there have been two challenge flags. And this is one where it's going to be a 3rd and 7 or 3rd and 10. It's not so much about the timeout they would lose if they lost the challenge. It's about having any more challenges.
Yeah, that's why I said I didn't agree with the call. The football, as he's going to the ground, defenders on him, and it definitely comes loose as he goes down. Even though the knees... That's going to be an incomplete pass, in my opinion. But the big thing is the challenge for that 3 yards, Jim. Now, if something happens the rest of this first half or the second half, Josh McDaniels cannot try to reverse a call.
Well, they're taking a longer look at this than you would think.
This tells you, I think, because where was the football? The clock, the time, there's a few situations you have to go over when you're going to reverse a call like this.
Bigger timing issue than anything. They know the chains over there on the far side of it. Go back to the 41.
That's right.
After reviewing the play, the ball hit the ground. The player lost possession. It's an incomplete pass. It'll be 3rd and 10. Please set the game clock to 10:01. 10:01, please. Denver will not be charged with a timeout, but that is their second replay challenge and final replay challenge.
That's a big deal.
Yeah, it is.
I'll tell you what, those 3 yards, is it worth it to not be able to have any kind of chance at a challenge?
So, of course, the football can hit the ground, but when it hits the ground like that, it comes loose. Incomplete.
A 3rd and 10 from the 41. And that's caught into traffic at the 37. And there's a late set of flags. 4 or 5 of them flying.
We got a bad ball.
After the play was over, unnecessary roughness, number 70 on the offense. It will be 4th down after the 15-yard penalty.
Let me ask you this. Had there not been that call against Mankins, it would have been about a 54-55-yard field goal try if they went that way with Gostkowski. Watch 70 come in at the back end of this.
Oh, yeah, definitely. The football, the play's over. Logan Mankins, Jim, absolutely. That's why they ran a draw play. They were going to just go for a long field goal. And the way they were going to kick it, I believe there's just a little breeze going that way.
Yeah, a little favorable.
So it would have helped them.
And Gostkowski had already made one from 53 going into the other direction. Into a slight breeze. So the penalty takes away any chance at the field goal. And it's Hansen. And he will not have this one return. Royal snags it back at the 8. 45-yard punt. A good one. Back inside the 10. Denver down 10. So there it was. The stubs from the first game back on September the 9th. 1960, Boston University Field, the Mingo punt return that won it. And they're breaking through wearing the uniforms of that day, what they look like of that day and era.
They actually wore their uniforms in practice on Friday.
A good point.
So Josh McDaniels said, let's just get this over with so we don't have to talk about a game day.
Orton in big trouble, and he is sacked. Patriots get to him. Ninkovich, backup linebacker, in on that.
Just the coverage down the field. Look at that. Nice protection to start with. And it's a 2-yard sack.
He's knocked down, sacked by his former Purdue teammate, Rob Ninkovich.
But when you're backed up as a quarterback, taking a 2-yard sack is not a bad thing. Be very careful with the football.
We'll call it 2nd and 13 with a play action. Looking across the middle, Marshall holds on. Took a couple of wallops. He's within a couple of a first. Merriweather popped him pretty good. Third and two coming up. Yeah, the coach didn't want them to be too shocked out here seeing all these vertical stripes, and they adjusted to it on Friday. The shock factor, if you will. And look at Marshall. He's got four catches now, all of the short variety. Marshall is becoming now, with each passing week after being suspended in training camp, that chemistry, it's coming on with Kyle Orton. Orton was very freely talking about it to us on Friday. Over the wall. He has the first and gets near the 30, working on Lee Botten. Gain of 10.
Well, what happens is with Brandon Stokley and Brandon Marshall on the backside away from where they are, Eddie Royal is going to get one-on-one coverage, and Botten does the right thing. He backs up, gives him a little space, and says to the Denver offense, and Kyle Orton, throw it to the sideline and complete the pass.
Moreno, remember, a little shaken up earlier. He's back in, and he was running to the right side. For New England called timeout. That's it for the Patriots in the half. They've used them all, but they lead 10-0. It was snowing here yesterday, and there was skiing up in the mountains. They had to cancel the Rockies playoff game with the Phillies. They'll play tonight. But it's warming up, and skies, in fact, brightening a little bit as we reach now a first down for the Broncos at the 28. Coming off a New England timeout, Orton from the pocket. Zips it in there with a flag down. Royal has it out at the 41.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Number 94, defense.
Well,
that 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the play.
That'll put the
automatic
football
first down
onto the New England side of the field.
Ty Warren, good protection. Boy, good job by Kyle Orton. Pulls it down.
Who?
And there is definitely a good step and a half afterwards. But Eddie Royal's the second read for Kyle Orton. He looked for Brandon Marshall first. He went from the right side deep to the left side deep. Got rewarded with a good completion.
Well, this whole issue about roughing the passer became such a big subject this week after a couple of calls went against the Ravens last week against the Patriots, and specifically with Tom Brady in the pocket. Our guys had a great debate on that topic on the NFL Today. From the 44, Orton, ball tipped and knocked down. Smart play by Brandon Marshall, saving a possible pick. Ninkovich was the one who batted it in the air.
It's a good time to look at the receiver in the middle of the field, wide open, but Ninkovich timing it perfectly, and that's what blitzing's all about. Catching him off guard, he waited, he hesitated. Nobody there to block him. And you said it, Jim, Brandon Marshall sees the football in the air and runs and knocks it down.
Ninkovich with a sack and a batted down pass on this drive. And there's Moreno for the first down. Quick explosion up the middle behind Hochstein and others. And Denver, remember, they had it second and 13 back at their own 7 on this drive. And now they're moving deep into New England territory.
Well, Hochstein comes across, and he blocks Vince Wilfork. And it opens up the hole. Nice move by Moreno. Well, he's got two hands on that football. He knows. If Buckhalter was healthy after that fumble, he might have been on the bench the rest of the day.
Got 48 yards here in the half on first down. Orton to Royal with another catch to the 17. Working on Lee Botten, who brought him down.
Good blocking. Good time, fast receivers. Kyle Orton really throwing the football very well. And this is the first game this year where he doesn't have the glove on the right hand either. His right index finger doesn't have a plastic shield over the top of it, doesn't have that glove. And he said it just gives him better feel. And, of course, he just trusts himself throwing the football.
Threw it for 15 yards on that hookup. And now inside the 20 from the red zone. Let's see what they do. Moreno sidesteps a hit and into the arms of Ty Warren.
He's down.
Looks like last week, doesn't it?
Down 10-0 against Dallas. You're talking about Denver coming back?
Yeah, down 10-0 and being pushed around just a little bit.
and then they just hung in there. And as the game went on, the Broncos just physically started to dominate. Here we go, Wild Horses. You were saying, when they're going to bring it back.
Here it is. Orton actually will come back under center. He eyes the defense and returns. Takes the snap, flings it to the 10. And that's Marshall, 2 yards short of a first. There's Kyle Orton. You look at his career. Of course, was a backup for so many years. Got a chance as a rookie to start some games for the Bears. They never really quite believed that he was their guy. And he came over in the deal for Cutler. He told us that he instantly knew. He was at a supermarket on his way home. Got the word, come on back. And he said, that instant, when I heard about it, I knew this was going to be a good deal for me going to Denver. And a third, we'll call it three. Pass caught, and it's a touchdown. Brandon Marshall, right over Sean Springs. Eleven-yard touchdown toss, Orton to Marshall.
Top of your screen, and Brandon Marshall so strong. And what you do is you end up fighting him, and then when you're still trying to get some leverage, he's already found the football and you haven't.
Crater in for the extra point. And it's 10-7 New England. You know, talking to Josh McDaniels, he had high praise for Marshall and his skills. He's a big receiver with small receiver skills, is what he had to say about him.
Yeah, it's quite a compliment. That he can play strong, he can go up in situations like this, outfight the defenders for the football, but also small receiver skills, quick out of breaks, runs good routes. Boy, it looked like last week against Terrence Newman, he just goes up, puts both hands on the football, and brings it in.
A 90-yard touchdown drive engineered by Orton. That's Denver's longest TD drive of this season.
The year goes, it's gone along here. This offense is really starting to take shape for the Denver Broncos. And they're executing a lot of plays well. It hasn't led to as many points as the number of plays they're executing.
Marshall coming up big, as he has in the last couple of years, 100 catch seasons. And Orton now with 6 touchdown passes on the season and no picks.
But what they're doing on the offensive side in the passing game, and Josh McDaniels, you've got to give a lot of credit. Kyle Orton's throwing it, of course, but it's clear. The reads are clear. The decisions. He's not having to throw the football into tight spaces.
Edelman and Slater, the two men back deep. Slater's kick travels only to the 3. It's Edelman. And makes it to the 25-yard line. Brought down by McBath. Tomorrow on CBS, when the most wanted man in Miami is murdered, the CSI team sets out to find his killer and his hidden treasure. It's an all-new CSI Miami, and it's tomorrow on America's number one network, CBS. Look at Orton's numbers, 14 of 17, 131 and a touch. Moss without a catch. First down, setting up screen to Falk. Falk splits defenders, takes it to the 33, give him 7, maybe 8.
Yeah, Randy Moss without a catch. And, you know, so far, Jim, it's not like they're doing anything special to take him away. The Patriots had one chance to hit him deep. Tom Brady missed it. But so far, it's been looking for the tight end and throwing to the running backs for the Patriots.
Roney in the backfield. And a sliding catch for a first. It's Welker. Goes for 13.
That football is up. Watch Welkin. Oh, nice sail to the outside. Tough for any linebacker to defend that. If he hits him in stride, it's going to be at least 20 more yards before a Bronco is going to be able to hit him.
Instead, he was able to cup it and scrape it off the ground, just above the ground. His fourth catch for 42 yards. Patriots trying to do a little business here before the half. Again, they're out of timeouts. Blitz, and Brady somehow got it away. That was DJ Williams in on him in a hurry. Brady strong enough to shake it off and at least get an incompletion out of it.
Oh, what a job on the blitz by DJ Williams. Inside, the New England Patriot offensive linemen got to be careful. When there's nobody there, you got to expect. You can't be double teaming. You got to expect the linebacker to show up.
And that's Maloney. Maybe a yard. You know, we were talking about that subject that came up on the NFL today. Brady last week. A couple of roughing the passer calls against the Ravens. This was the one that really got Baltimore upset. They went low after Brady. They were flagged for it. What was your thought on that?
You know, Jim, the rule is clear. When you make the action, that's all you have to do. You know, Terrell Suggs, he didn't mean to go low, but he did. And when in doubt, the officials will always throw the flag when it comes to player safety.
Third down and 9. Open is Welker. And he takes it to the Broncos 37, picks up 17. Boy, is he reliable. Ran away from Alphonso Smith. We've reached the 2-minute warning. 10-7 Patriots.
Well, watch Tom Brady. He's going to look to the right. That's Wes Welker to the left. He looks. Nobody's open. And then he comes to his outlet receiver. How about that? Your outlet receiver is 10 to 15 yards down the field, breaking outside.
2 minutes to go in the half. Patriots, no timeouts. First down, Denver 37.
That's what makes this offense unique.
Brady having to move around a little bit, still untouched. Gets it to Falk to the 21. Boy, they're giving Brady time, except that one hit by DJ Williams. That goes for 16.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. The only time they're getting pressure on Tom Brady is some type of unique look or a blitz. When it's the four down defensive lineman, the Patriots are winning that battle every time.
Welker bobbles it, holds on to the 10 and a first down.
Plenty of time.
Yep. Well, Welker looks like he was a little shaken up after the catch. Got 1:17 to go. Got hit in the back.
Yes, that's what it is. Brian Dawkins.
He's missed a game earlier this season, which is a rarity for him. And you see this drive's covered 64 yards. They ran 10 seconds off the clock there, Phil, because they're out of timeouts inside of 2 minutes and an injury. It's a first and goal to go right at the 10. Bring the clock from 117 to 107. Edelman now in the slot, taking Welker's position. Run it with Falk. He stumbles before the hit and confirmed down right at the 10. Bonnie Holiday and Wesley Woodyard. Welker coming right back out. He's in a slot to the left. Second and goal. Throw it to the seven. It's Falk. Third down on the way. We've got the Sprint halftime report coming up. JB and all the guys with the scores and highlights. Recaps of the early games coming up on the Sprint halftime report. Clock running inside of 20. Third and goal to go.
He throws it in bounds. They better be ready to run that field goal team on.
Brady to the end zone. Touchdown, Benjamin Watson.
They wouldn't have made it. But Tom Brady, the New England sideline, was screaming, trying to get his attention. I'm sure he was aware of what was going on. But Ben Watson inside, nice fake, comes across. There's a mix-up in there by the linebackers. One's playing man-to-man coverage, the other's playing zone. And that's why Ben Watson was wide open.
74 yards, the Patriots drive in 4 minutes and 26 seconds. Brady and Watson work it out with 5 seconds to go in the half.
Watch what the linebackers do, Jim, inside. Nobody goes with Ben Watson. Oh, and then it's too late when you decide you do have to go with him.
Well, you get in the last 2 or 3 minutes of a first or second half, and Watson has been Brady's go-to guy. Remember what he did with those 2 tosses to Watson week 1 against Buffalo? 2 touchdowns, another one here. Outscoring opponents 28-0 in the last 3 minutes of the halves. And again, the Sprint halftime report with JB, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer, Coach Cower. The latest scores and highlights coming up out of Studio 43 in New York.
As Mike Nolan, the defensive coordinator, said to me, you always take a priority list. He goes, okay, the Patriots, let's see. Well, we want to make sure we take care of Randy Moss. Oh, then there's Wes Welker. You know, this Ben Watson, he's really good. Oh, and Kevin Falk, he's a great situational player. We got to keep. And then Tom Brady goes, ah, you got the picture. So there's a long list. And what you take away, the Patriots don't care. They just go down the line and they work to that next receiver. And that's why Ben Watson was wide open on that touchdown throw. The defense was focused to the outside. The middle was open.
Well, it was really Welker who did a lot of the hard work down the field. Has 6 catches today. New England now has scored more points here in the first half than Denver's allowed in any other game this year. They had never given up more than 10 points in a game. And a squib kick. Eckstein has it out at the 40. And from that point, why not launch one?
No, it might be too far.
Wouldn't try to just get some kind of pass interference call or something?
You know me, I do, but I wouldn't do it just because what could go wrong, somebody getting hit. And I don't think, well, of course, if it's pass interference, Jim, you get one more untimed play. I don't think Kyle Orton can throw it 65 yards.
Randy Moss is playing deep.
Knock it down.
Maybe make his first catch of the day. There's a pick. Here's Orton. He is going to launch it deep.
That is wrong.
And he's got it all the way to the goal line. In fact, it is Moss with the catch. His first grab of the day. And that is Orton's first interception of the season.
Well, I'll say this. I like the call by Josh McDaniels in this respect. He saw an opportunity and was trying to take advantage of it, where most coaches just go ahead, kneel, and go inside. Look at those red gloves.
So Moss has no catches from Brady. 1 catch off the arm of Orton. 17-7 halftime. Sprint halftime report coming up here on CBS. Second half about to get started. Jim Nantz with Phil Sims here. And remember, New England had won the toss and elected to take the football in the second half. The Patriots, who are for the 5th straight week playing a team without a loss. A reminder, this game brought to you in high definition here on CBS. You open up, of course, week 1. But every week thereafter, the team they played was undefeated, including 4-0 Denver in this case. A 10-point lead for New England beginning the second half, and they certainly looked in rhythm on that last drive, didn't they? Prater putting the toe to it. And the run back from the three, it's Edelman. We'll start at the 26. Your thoughts on that first half there, partner? What did you see?
Well, I saw a lot of good things by both football teams, but the difference, Wes Welker. I mean, it just really came down to that. He kept a couple drives going for the New England Patriots, and when Tom Brady was in trouble, he got open, and that was the difference.
And shaken up for only one play. It looked like he was really laid out on that one catch down to about the 10, but he was able to toughen up and come right back out, and he's on the field, set wide to the right. First snap of the second half from the 26. Brady sings it, and it's almost intercepted off the fingertips of Welker. Champ Bailey was over there guarding. And that first half, again, Brady 152 and two touchdowns. The Denver receivers, that'd be Gaffney, Royal, and Marshall catching the touchdown right here. Had 12 grabs, 110 yards.
As I watch the plays on both teams, on the offenses, they mirror each other in so many ways because, of course, Josh McDaniels working there and they've kept the same offense, but the difference is Denver does not have a Wes Welker yet.
And as Watson, driven down by Davis, about 3-4 yards short of the first.
And I know you, they go, well, they don't have Tom Brady either. Well, of course not, but Kyle Orton has played solid all year long and he's played very well here today.
Kyle Orton just the one pick, and that was just on a Hail Mary before the half, intercepted by Randy Moss, who out of this huddle has not had a reception today. Moss with a pick, but no catches. Welker lined up, flanking Brady to the left. And there's Moss shifting to a slot right. New England. And off the hands of Moss, a pass a little steep. That's the first time today they failed to convert.
That's two times Tom Brady's had Randy Moss open, and both times he's missed him long. This time, it's high. Tom Brady has the time, he's got the coverage he wants, and he is upset because he knows, hey, just what we want, Randy Moss open for about a 15-yard game.
They had hit their five previous third down attempts, now 5 of 9. And it falls on Hanson. Royal, fair catch, dives to make it at the 27. So a three and out forced by the Broncos. Trailing 17-7.
Now watch Alfonso Smith of the Broncos. He's hitting Brett Lockett. Pulls his jersey down. Hey, let me help you. Gentleman's game, Tim. Yeah, so you can appreciate that.
Yes, gentleman. A gentleman's game it is.
Yes. That was nice.
That was a nice touch. 28-yard line. Starting point for Denver. And Moreno, just a couple for the rookie. What did you think of Orton in that first half?
Well, I thought it was flawless by him, really, Jim. Every time there was a guy open, he put the football on the money. A lot of short passes. But as it went along the first half, I thought Josh McDaniels and the receivers really kind of got it going. And they started throwing quite a few completions down the field.
His wild horses formation brings Orton back under center. On second and 8, he's got the first down. And that is Tony Scheffler.
That was a really nice read by Scheffler and Kyle Orton. Watch Scheffler as he breaks to the sidelines. He knows there could be a defender there, so he sits down, and Kyle Orton throws it to his inside shoulder to make him slow down so he doesn't run and get hit too hard.
Bottom trying to reach around and knock it loose.
I think he's 5 for 5 out of the wild horses.
Little play action on first down, and pocket is sealed. He goes underneath as his players were well guarded downfield. Moreno for 5.
Tell you what all this is doing. Just look at the space and the time Kyle Orton has to throw the football. And look at the receivers going down the field. They're looking. That play was really designed to throw it deep and over the top. The Patriots stay back. They don't give up many long throws.
Moreno with a good burst for a first. And a flag thrown in at the end. Moreno shaken up momentarily. And he's hobbling off.
There are fouls by both teams on the play. Defense, 12 men, holding number 73 on the offense. Those fouls offset, second down.
Moreno could hit. Knee in a little awkward position.
Second down and five for Broncos.
Patriots caught again, personnel-wise. That's why they had 12 guys on the field.
It's a second and five, so take away the first. And Orton gets one anyway. It's Big Daniel Graham, the former Patriot, to the 43. Picks up 10.
Boy, Kyle Orton is getting some time. Look at the defense, how it spreads apart. Little double move on the inside by Daniel Graham. Not quite as effective as when we see Wes Welker do it, but the results are good. Completion and another first down for the Broncos.
Graham's first catch. First down from the 43. Lamont Jordan is the running back. And a reverse, and Orton's out there waiting to throw a block. Marshall has it. And he's pushed it out of bounds at the 37. Picks up six. And that's Will Height down on the sideline for New England. Slow to get up.
Let me just see if the Broncos were in a legal formation. I wasn't sure. There was nobody on the end of the line of scrimmage. But they get away with it. Kyle Orton got in the way down there.
Yeah, he's looking for somebody to hit, and he finally decided to take on Mayo.
Could second, have been a flag, but not called.
Second down and four. Moreno's back. Fake to him. Stepping away from the pressure. Orton's pass wide. There's a flag. Back in the area where that was thrown, and now one back in the area where Shepard was trying to catch it. There's one at the line of scrimmage, one in the secondary.
There are fouls by both teams on the play. Holding, number 89, offense. Holding, number 30, defense. Those fouls offset, second down.
So with those penalties offset officially so far, Denver still without an official penalty, one that has been put into play.
Daniel Graham on the outside of the hole. Brandon McGowan, oh, look at that, nice pull.
McGowan getting a fingertip on it, but we'll replay the down. From the New England 37, second down. This is Moreno, and another flag coming in.
Well, the umpire threw it. That's going to be offensive holding.
Holding, number 50, offense. 5-10 yard penalty, second down.
Ben Hamilton called for that. So it's gotten a little flag happy here on this drive.
Well, I kind of talked in the first half how New England's offensive line was blocking Denver's defensive line when there was no blitzing and no unusual movement. Same can be said, the Broncos really doing a tremendous job. Kyle Orton, plenty of time, able to move when nobody's open until they do get open.
Second and 14, and reaching out to knock it down is Bodden. Eddie Royal was the receiver.
Coverage was tighter that time by the Patriots. They said, enough of this, throwing it down the field with us not contesting the throws. Good job by Lee Bodden. plays it properly from the outside because he knows he has somebody helping him out inside and waits till the last second to put that arm across and break it up.
So third down for Denver, New England 47-yard line. Tip and caught by the Broncos. And no, they're not in Cincinnati. They like these deflection plays. It's Jabbar Gaffney that finally brings it in, and then Morton can only laugh about it.
Yeah, this time Jabbar Gaffney goes down in the middle. Nobody's there, but what a recovery by McGowan. And 90% of the time when a football is tipped down the middle like that, it's going to be intercepted by the defense.
No, he's going for Gaffney all along. What's the big deal? Back to the Wild Horses. And reminiscent, if you will, a little snapshot of what it was like against the Bengals week one. Here's an open Daniel Graham bringing a Patriot defender, Merriweather, with him. 18 yards gained.
Jim, you said it to me during a commercial. I don't know why Denver doesn't go back to the Wild Horses. Once again, look at it. Nobody in coverage. A little different look by the Patriots at time. They blitzed. First time I've seen them blitz that formation.
So out of the Wild Horses. Going to take off with it. Moreno. That middle is pretty clogged. And Wilford holds the ground. Holds them to 2 yards.
I don't think they've missed a pass play out of it. The running plays have been okay. But it has definitely made it simpler and easier for Kyle Orton once he gets underneath the center after shifting from the outside to make completions.
Second down and 8. Got Marshall set wide to the left. He looks right though. And it's over to Royal, out of bounds, just outside the 5. Really close to a first.
Well, you got to respect Eddie Royal, so you have to give him a little room. The timing by Kyle Orton, very good, right in rhythm, and throwing the football right on target.
Measure it here. King Gang only has to advance by about a yard from off the sideline, and it'll be 3rd and inches. Impressive drive by the Broncos. Their first possession of the second half. They've taken it 66 yards. They're 5 yards away from the end zone. And maybe 5 inches away, though, first for a first down.
You know, it's kind of interesting, though, is that, Jim, we did the game last week. The Patriots playing the Baltimore Ravens. I thought they blitzed the Ravens quite a bit. You know, more than I expected them to. But today, playing it very cautious on the defensive side. And Denver's taking advantage of it.
Moreno is stuck in the backfield and loses a little bit. It's Wilford. Wilford just breaking through. He was challenging Ben Hamilton, and now it's 4th and less than a yard.
Well, I thought he was going to go for it for a second. Josh McDaniels was actually looking at that play sheet. That would have been a bad call.
You're down 2 scores, a chance to get it within 7.
Yeah, keep the momentum going a little bit in your way. And you're right, get it down to 1 score.
Prater missed from 48 yards on the game's opening drive. This is 24 yards. And Prater drives it through. We got a 7-point game here at Invesco. 17-10 New England, 3rd quarter. And we're back here in Denver, and our Skycam presented by Astro Boy, the movie.
Well, I'll probably go check it out.
Will you?
Yeah, I always like to. I go on the premises. I get young kids and take them just so it doesn't look too bad. You know what I mean? Wouldn't look good if I went by myself.
No, it definitely would not. But you said you've heard good things, so.
Yes, I have.
Have a good time. 12-play drive for the Broncos. And 66 yards. They got it down to the 5, and a big hit by Wilford.
Wilford, Vince Wilford. Find out where he's lined up, and just make sure you don't run at him. Just one of the top run stoppers in the NFL. There's some good ones out there right now. Aloney Nantz, the Baltimore Ravens, comes to mind.
That drive really aided by that deflection catch by Daphne on third down. Crater sends it down to Edelman. Sudden jerky turn, and he gets outside to the 30. Good piece of running by the rookie to the 35. 33-yard run back. And we're back here. Jim Nantz, Phil Simms, and New England out on the field at the 34-yard line. It's Maroney. Cuts back. Going outside. Gains 5. Wait till you find out what Charlie's brother is doing to earn some extra money tomorrow on a new 2.5 Men right here on CBS, America's Most Watched Network. Second and 5, and a fake to Maroney. And a wide open with a flag down. Oh, Moss thought about lateraling it to Welker. He holds on to it to the 25. There is a flag in the secondary.
Yeah, it's going to be on Denver. They bumped Randy Moss about 15 yards down the field. Tremendous play action fake. And they gave
prior to the pass, illegal contact, number 20 of the defense. That penalty's declined. First down.
36 yards here. Matches Brady's longest pass play of the season.
See, look at the fake. There's the contact. But look, there's no underneath coverage. And Champ Bailey, his job was to make sure Randy Moss did not get deep. So that created such a void, easy throw for Tom Brady.
And that's the longest play in this game. Maroney. Zimmerville has him. After a gain of 4.
I was just getting ready to talk about Randy Moss and go, well, one of the reasons you're not throwing a lot of footballs to him because Champ Bailey is on his side. But you got to use your talent a lot of different ways. That's typical New England. We've seen it over the years. Mike Vrabel, Randy Moss, defensive lineman in at fullback.
At the Denver 22. Pass over to Morris. All broken up by Jack Williams.
What a job. Jack Williams says, I've seen this play about 50 times during training camp by our offense. That's why we're not seeing as many quick screens by either team. Those quick throws to the outside, the receivers, because they both do it so much, so their defenses see it all during training camp, all offseason. They react to it very well.
A 3rd and 7. Drop back into the gun. Denver rushing 3. Brady. Denver says incomplete. Officials agree. It was intended for Welker. Brian Dawkins. Put the hit on Welker again.
Yeah, Jim, the pressure, they were collapsing the pocket so Tom Brady could feel it. Watch the rushers as they go back, and they collapse it so Brady now locks onto Wes Welker and doesn't have a chance to look for that second receiver, and Wes Welker is very well covered.
It's going to set up a 40-yard field goal attempt from a right hash mark. Gostkowski. Already with a career long from 53, good. This one from 40, hooking. No good. wide left. Only his second miss of the season. He had made his last 12 kicks. This one fractionally wide. Still a 7-point game. The ball will be placed here at the 30 after the missed field goal. With 5:15 to go, third quarter. Oh, and almost. Bodden got a hand in there, so Gaffney unable to take off with it. If you can't get enough fantasy football, play NFL.com's Fantasy Challenge games. Playbook Challenge, where every yard equals a point, or Touchdown Challenge. Start your own touchdown streak today only at NFL.com/fantasy.
Quick passes. The defenders are getting a little closer to these quick passes. So you just wonder, will the Denver Broncos do a little double move?
Fortune goes to Graham. He's gotten into the action here in the second half with three catches. That goes for 6 yards.
Well, he gets in the action because this offense, without a doubt, it's predicated to looking to the wide receivers first. Sometimes one on the right, one all the way over to the left. Then you find your secondary receiver, which would be Daniel Graham or a running back.
Daniel Graham's father, Tom, was a linebacker for the Broncos back in the early 70s and led the team in tackles in 73, playing with the likes of Tom Jackson and Randy Gradishar. Third down throw, and it's good enough for the first. It's Gaffney. Gain of 6.
Jabbar Gaffney, a couple times in this game when he's the slot receiver on third down, the Patriots have double-teamed him. That's what they think of him. Remember, he played for the Patriots, and Tom Brady told us last week when he was there with Dante Stallworth, Wes Welker, and Randy Moss, what did he say? That's just a dream. It's a dream to have that group together.
Gaffney really maybe underrated in his days that he was with New England. As Orton shifts back under center on first down. Got an open man, it's Scheffler. And he takes it to the New England side as the Broncos are trying to drive for a tying score.
Now you tell me, do you think anybody's going to copy this offense of the Broncos? One, against anybody, and two, against the Patriots. Receiver down the field, another receiver, oh, and there's the third one. So pretty hard for a defender to figure out who he wants to focus on. And the Wild Horses offense, I mean, it is the passing game out of it is terrific.
Lamont Jordan crashes to the 42. It really does give Orton, though, a chance to scan the field, doesn't it?
Well, it's making the Patriots play a defense, what you call a shell three. It's safe. All quarterbacks would like to throw against that type of defense every down. If they could, the passer ratings would be off the charts by everybody. And two things, the receivers are getting open, and Kyle Orton is getting a lot of time to throw when they're in those situations.
It's a better version of the Wildcat, you think?
Absolutely.
An upgrade, huh?
No question. It'll be copied.
Jordan again. With the 39, they'll sub third and about three. So
I don't know if there's a... My first thought is, what would be the answer? I don't know, because if you put that running back there like Sean Marino, well, you better honor him catching the ball and running it. And then so you get the run defense set, are you quick enough to change everything over when the quarterback comes under there? I don't know. That's pretty tough chore for the defense.
And again, they'll go conventional on third down. Third and three. Hit right away. Boy, almost on the exchange. Tully Bantakane. Loss of three.
Oh, yes. Graham looks like he's trying to get outside to seal it inside. Oh, yes. That's what he did. Tully Bantakane, he recognized it, read it quick, came inside, and just ruined the play. That's why you got to stay head up on blockers and then work your way to the angle you want.
They ran it those last three plays and almost got that one blocked. Bounces at the six. And it's covered up at the two. McBath is there to down it. Oh, and it was almost blocked. Kern, 38 yards. Pat Chung almost blocked it.
Watch, Brett. Watch the punter, Kern. How nimble he is. Chung almost blocks it. He hangs in the air and hurdles. It really saves the Patriots from getting a 15-yard personal foul. But a good job by McBath, knowing the situation, not going in the end zone.
Pins the Patriots back at the 4-yard line. Spread it out from the end zone. Brady throws and over the head of Moss. College football next Saturday, Home Depot SEC on CBS. And you will see in that game Arkansas at number one Florida. That's next Saturday. It all begins with the TIAA Crep College Football Today. Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson have the call. Tim and Spencer in the studio. Florida, Arkansas, next Saturday on CBS.
You haven't heard the name Elvis Dumervil today. Matt Light is getting help every once in a while, but he's done a terrific job on him.
Brady, 2 out of 7 in this half. Quick toss over to Welker. And hit quickly by Dawkins, but at least he got it out to the 10-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 4.
I tell you, in the Broncos, give them credit. They're equal opportunity people. They moved Dumervil around, and they put him on the other side, too, against Nick Kasher. But he's done a good job, too.
It's amazing how many people came in. Patchwork defense, a lot of veterans, 8 new starters. They gave up 10 points here in the first quarter. Now looking for a big stop here on 3rd down. 17-10 New England. Final minute, 3rd quarter. Brady's pass is incomplete. In the area of Welker.
What a job. Elvis Dumervil, 92, standing up on the outside, trying to find a way, follows a blocker in. It doesn't work, but Wes Welker went all the way across the field, stopped, and is trying to work his way back.
Well, Bill Belichick coached 1 year in Denver. He was the special teams coach for the Broncos back in 1978. Let's check out this special teams action. As Hansen, he falls, and he gets the flag. They got a roughing the punter. So instead of having the football at the New England 49, it was 4th and 4.
Running into the kicker, number 95 on the defense. That 5-yard penalty results in a 1st down.
Darrell Reed, the former Colt. Oh, that's a big one.
Who's a really just an outstanding special teams player.
They got a little piece of the left leg.
Well, and you know, the first thought is, oh, come on, it wasn't bad. We've already had that discussion. We talked about roughing the passer. It's the action. The leg was out there. You ran into it. If you're going to tell the officials, let's decide, well, was it really bad or not? Josh McDaniel says, I don't know who he's yelling at. I think he's yelling at Darrell Reed.
Boy, he is hot. He knows that was a crucial call against his team. Bad mistake by Reed. They would have had the football in New England territory. 1st down run, Morris. Well, chipped early by Goodman. No gain.
They're hot. Josh McDaniels is hot, Jim, because the emotion is on their side big time right now.
That closes the 3rd quarter. Back after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Back here in Denver with Tom Brady through 2 touchdowns in the 1st half. To lead him to a 10-point lead at the intermission. Here, Welker for one, Watson for another.
Well, when this game is over, if the Patriots win, look at the numbers of the quarterbacks. Tom Brady will be happy, but he won't be, says he'll be thinking about those couple throws that he missed. One to keep a drive going, the other for the touchdown.
And he hasn't always had success against Denver by any means. 1-5. That includes a playoff loss. He had another four-pick game against him once. Nothing like that today as he is back working it with Welker again for another first down. We got an update. Let's go to New York.
Jim and Phil, two of the best wide receivers in the game on display, Andre Johnson and Larry Fitzgerald. This one here to Andre Johnson from Metchoff. He does the rest, 11 yards to pay dirt, six catches, 78 yards, and a touchdown. They've narrowed the gap there. 21-14, Arizona. Back to Jim Nantz and Phil Sims.
And I have a much-respected left tackle here, James, for the Patriots. Matt Light is down. And we're going to take a break in the action here as the fourth quarter is just underway. I think Matt Light helped to the bench. Here's what happened. Own player, Dan Copen, inadvertently running into the back of the right leg. Sebastian Vollmer, a rookie tackle out of the University of Houston now on that left side. On first down, it's Falk. And he's tripped up by D.J. Williams.
Yeah, Jim, you figured it would be a run. First play, let him get in there and get his feet wet. Because you know Elvis Dumervil was over there on him, on Vollmer. And so he's going to go up the field looking to try to get quarterback pressure, run the draw play right underneath him.
Sammy Morris is the running back. Second down, six. And Morris gets the handoff. He has a chance to say hello to Vonnie Holiday. Picks up three. Third down coming up.
Well, just another name. Vonnie Holiday, not in the starting unit, but so many players brought in by this coaching staff and the organization, new to the defensive side. And, you know, a lot like the Patriots, everybody has very specific roles. Vonnie Holiday comes in on third downs. Anytime he thinks it's a passing situation, him and Darrell Reed are usually the inside pass rushers.
Already stopped the Patriots once on this drive, but the Patriots got to come back out there with an offensive unit after a running into the punter. Penalty. Falk. Flag down. Dumervil won't let go. We'll check the flag. Now they picked up the flag, Phil. No gain for Falk.
Still, they gained some yards. Running in the kicker, they picked up a first down, so it helps field position for the New England Patriots.
Uh-oh.
That could be
New England signaling that Denver side may have jumped early, and again, it would be enough for a first. It was fourth and two. Can this special teams punt unit of Denver make a second big mistake?
Neutral zone infraction.
Oh, yes.
Number 81 defense.
Wow.
His movement into the neutral zone caused a reaction by the offense. That 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Wow. Really big. Was there anybody on the offensive side that flinched? Everybody has some moves. Nope. It is
Richard Quinn.
Richard Quinn does it on his own.
Rookie. Special teams coach.
Yes, Prefer.
Denver had only one penalty in the game called on against it before this drive, and twice now the punt return unit for Denver has given the ball right back to New England on penalties. Morris takes it to the 45, picks up six. Wednesday on Showtime, the Emmy Award winning Inside the NFL is back with JB and Phil, Chris Collinsworth, Warren Sapp, longest running show on cable. We'll be seeing you Wednesday night, Phil, Inside the NFL on Showtime.
Yes, make sure you watch. With Mike Prefer, special teams coach for the Broncos, I don't think he's standing too close to Josh McDaniels.
Ooh,
here.
I think McDaniels was hot before. Now times two, and Morris. I think he's going to get it with the forward progress. He does. He'll have the first near the 49. And rookie left tackle Vollmer threw a good block for him that time. Vollmer was taken in the second round.
Where's he from? What school?
That would be the University of Houston.
Oh, did he graduate? Just seems like a lot of guys I know from Houston didn't graduate.
Hey, easy.
No, just kidding.
That is not nice.
Oh, I'm just kidding.
You're dead. Here is Morris. And it's Dawkins for 2 yards.
And I know there's a lot of reasons for this play selection by the Patriots, but I think a lot of it has to do just to protect their left tackle and to settle the crowd down. There's nothing like running the football and making the defense settle down, get the crowd to sit on their hands.
And they've had the football for almost 6 minutes.
And help a rookie left tackle. Looks like pass, just the way he's so far set back in the backfield.
And second down and 8. Boy, Brady have time. He's going for the big ball. Dawkins had a play on the pick. That was going to Michael Matthews, their third team tight end. He was the one closest to it.
Jim, I don't think he was throwing to anybody. He saw Randy Moss just down there, and he said, let me just throw it up in the air and see what happens. We've seen him do it in the past, a three-man rush. Boy, that helps out a rookie left tackle. I believe he was throwing it to Randy Moss. Dawkins, good job. Getting there. Matthews just flying across the field.
Dawkins is out on this play. He went to the sideline. And a timeout called by the New England side. Third and 8 coming up. A drive over 6 minutes that has been stopped twice by the Denver defense, only to give new life to the Patriots with special team penalties against the Broncos. Another third down right here. Third and 8 from the 48. For Welker, deflected and then almost intercepted, then almost caught. Bailey had a play on it, then Welker on the rebound almost picked up the first.
Patriots keep extra guys in because they want to throw it down the field. Good route by Wes Welker. Look at Champ Bailey. He got his hand in there. A pretty unique route. Wes Welker trying to make Champ Bailey think he's going to the sideline. He stops, comes back inside. But look at that right hand of Bailey's in between to knock it out.
Receiving word, Matt Light, it's a knee injury, doubtful to return. He's already been taken to the locker room. And the Royals trying to run away from it, and look at it fielded by Slater at the 1 yard line. 100 in the winning touchdown throw to Caldwell with seconds to go. That pass going to Moreno. How about the effort down the field by Matthew Slater, the son of Jackie Slater. Royal runs away from it. And a little ballerina, ballet act, I should say. And Orton says, oh, man.
it's torture for a quarterback when you're backed up because there's so many things to think about. And it's hard to be a clear thinker because if you get in trouble, you're worried about getting in trouble, so you think fast. And that usually is wrong.
Well, they can hook up here for a first down. That's Gaffney with the catch and the ball. He was down. It came out. Remember, they already did.
Ruling on the field.
He had a 90-yard touchdown drive.
Contact the yardage results in a first down.
First half for Denver. Their one touchdown was on a 90-yard drive.
Even though nice play by the Broncos, two receivers cutting across the middle. Even if this football did come loose, they ruled forward progress. It stopped. That's what I thought the official. Bill Belichick's going to challenge it because that football did come out before he hit the ground. But I thought the side judge said forward progress was stopped. And that's what I think you're going to tell him. I heard somebody say
it. I heard it. I just heard it. Forward progress.
Yep.
Bill just said forward progress.
And, you know, I'll tell you, Jim, you heard the whistle. You saw the stoppage of play.
The ruling on the field was that the runner's forward progress was stopped. That aspect is not reviewable. First down, Denver.
Going to pick up the red flag.
But we said many times today that they're letting the plays go. In other words, wait. Let it finish. That football's coming loose. It's close. It is definitely moving, I think, before he went on the ground, but it doesn't matter.
So the football's at the 16. Moreno slashes out to the 21. Hey, Arizona was up 21-0 on Houston. Big comeback on the way, JB. What's the latest there?
Jim, it is 21 unanswered points by Houston. Jim and Phil, take a look at the talent that is Andre Johnson. Here from Matt Schaub, 17-yard strike, not one, not two, but a third effort, taking it across into the end zone, all knotted at 21 in Arizona. Back to Jim and Phil.
What a comeback. That's two touchdown catches by Johnson in the quarter. Back from 21 down on the road, and Orton's in trouble. Gets it away, and Eddie Royal has it out at the 30 for another first down.
What a job by Kyle Orton. He had to see out of a corner of his eye that it was a blitz.
Will Height was chasing
it. Yes, it's Will Height. Couldn't see who it was. Coming from the inside receiver. Unblocked. And moves to his right, makes another completion.
Started back at the 3. And now first down at the 32. Orton sips it in the area of Royal, who claims he was held past the 5 yards. We got another doubleheader weekend coming up next Sunday. Early, many will see Baltimore at Minnesota. The Vikings remain undefeated today with their win at St. Louis. And late, we'll be in New England for Tennessee and the Patriots. It all gets started with the NFL today. Presented by Southwest Airlines next Sunday at noon. JB, Dan, Shannon, Coach Cower, and Boomer.
You know, Patriots just not able to even get close to Kyle Orton. Plenty of time to throw the football.
Moreno, wide open gap ahead, and he's down to the New England 41. Once he got past that first Patriot, it was daylight for 27 yards.
What a timely call. They got him flying up the field. That's what it's all about when it comes to a lot of times successful plays in the NFL is when you call them. Good releasing by the lineman, Chris Cooper. Look at Casey Wigman, way down the field. His block and the fact that he got down there gave Moreno an extra 10 yards.
Longest play of the day for the Broncos, 27 yards. Orton to Royal. Bouncing around and he's to the 35. Well, Orton trying to do what Frank Trepucka did in September of 1960, as we mentioned. You may have not been with us earlier, but this was the matchup, the first game ever in AFL history. Denver and the Boston Patriots. Trepucka and the Broncos went to Boston and beat them 13-10. Trepucka threw the first touchdown pass in AFL history. Notre Dame legend. Spawned a son into NBA All-Star form. And he's in the Ring of Honor and watching today from Essex Fells, New Jersey, as that pass is knocked down.
It's really, as you watch this game today, and the Broncos have executed so many plays and done it right, it's hard to, you look up and you go, they're losing 17-10. So that's really the, has been the history of Bill Belichick, that his teams give a little, but they know how to stop you. They keep from scoring those points. They make you try to kick field goals. And they eliminate one part of your game, and that's running the football consistently.
Probably four down territory with 6:39 to go from the 35. Need to get to the 32 to come after Orton. Unloads it. Royal has it. First down at the 29.
Well, the one thing that happens to a quarterback when your running game is not working and you get decent protection, you start making throws like this. Kyle Orton in good rhythm, good blitz pickup, and makes a very tight throw to the outside to Eddie Royal.
Moreno holding it with two hands. He's not going to cough it up like he did in that first half. That goes for seven.
So quick through the hole. You said it. We saw it early on a replay. It is double lockdown. Yes. Look at that.
That is. No way.
He's got an arm around each point of the football. I mean, his hands. And it is secured to his body. Going to try to throw it to him this play.
Second short. There's the pass, and it's off the fingertips. And a flag is thrown on Merriweather. Late hit on Royal. Or is it taunting? It was deflected first by Bodden. They were going for Eddie Royal.
Well, since the football was deflected, if it was pass interference, then it will be called off. If it was a late hit out of bounds.
Hey, we got this. Come on.
After the pass was incomplete, taunting number 31 of the defense, that penalty will be measured half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
Couple after the play penalties today by the Patriots. We saw one earlier. Hits him.
This
gets
move,
up.
This move right here.
Right. Well, wait. Yeah. No. He taunting. Threw the flag before he
yeah.
made the move.
Kind of did, didn't he?
So that flag, that must have been thinking it was pass interference. The other flag came from inside who saw the taunting, Jim.
Yeah, because as you said, the ball had been deflected, so it couldn't be a pass interference
yes.
ball.
So
first down at the 11. Marshall fights for it, and Marshall gets it. Touchdown, Denver. Broke away from Bodden. And just as he did against Dallas a week ago, he was not going to be denied the end zone. His second touchdown of the day, his first catch of the second half, and it's a big one.
Well, a little fake or feint to the inside, and then when he turns outside, we said it many times, Jimmy. So big and strong, going to be hard to bring him down right at the point of attack.
That is a 98-yard touchdown drive. And the extra point ties it. Denver's longest touchdown drive since 2006. And the game is tied with 5:21 to go. The Denver defense has shut out New England here in the second half, and they've gone now on two drives of at least 90 yards. And for those of you expecting to see 60 minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS, Patriots and Broncos, all tied. Jim Nantz here with Phil Simms. 60 minutes coming up after the game, except for those of you on the West Coast, you'll see it at your normal time. Edelman to the 22. Tom Brady. Another fourth quarter challenge for Brady, the master at these winning drives, 29 times.
Yeah, a couple things. Crowd noise, my gosh, has it been loud here today. And now, I thought the Patriots, especially, you know, the last drive, when Matt Light got hurt, they were very careful in their play calling. They'll try to help out the left tackle, Vollmer, when they can. But now it's about going out and winning the game. Two backs in the backfield, that usually means you're going to make sure protection first.
Set up screen right side, Morris. Bailey comes up, helps bring him down at the 25, gains five.
How about that? Champ Bailey, we talk about him all the time, what a coverage corner he is, but he's an all-around corner, comes up and makes tackles too.
Second and six. Morris runs into his own teammate, Mankins, and then is stopped at the 27. We'd like to welcome those of you who saw Seattle steamroll Jacksonville today behind Hasselbeck's four touchdown passes. Two to Burleson, two to Husmanzada, as the Seahawks smashed him 41-0. Jim Nantz, Bill Sims, and it's been a good one here in Denver. All tied. Broncos were down 17-7 at halftime. Orton just took him on a 98-yard tying touchdown drive and a timeout called by the Broncos. Defense wants to make sure it's set with a big third down on the way for New England. A divisional playoff game won by the Broncos, and Bailey, you'll never forget Benjamin Watson's effort running him down and knocking that ball out right at the goal line. And Super Bowl 44 on CBS, 118 days away.
Boy, that seems like a long time.
It'll be here soon.
Okay.
Watson, by the way, he's on the sideline. He suffered a head injury earlier in this half, and we were told he probably would not return. They've already lost their left tackle. For those of you just joining us, Matt White out with a knee injury. Josh McDaniels, the pupil, going against the mentor, Bill Belichick. Orton just hit Brandon Marshall for the second time today to tie the game on third down. Almost picked, but Dawkins had his back turned. But the ball coming back to Denver.
Oh, it's a touchdown. If the throw is on Wes Welker, it's a touchdown to your left.
I thought
it's a touchdown. Dawkins came up inside. Look at Wes Welker. The technique by Goodman to the outside. He thinks there's somebody deep. Nobody there.
4 minutes to go. Broncos are going to get it back. A rookie snapping it back. Ingram to Hanson. And two Broncos in the area. There a little confusion. And that was Alphonso Smith snatching it away from Eddie Royal. We've got another update on Arizona-Houston. Back to you, James Brown.
Hey, Jim and Phil, here's a go-ahead touchdown by Arizona. Matt Schaub dropping back. Picked off by Dominic Rogers-Cromartie. He takes it, Jim, 49 yards to the end zone. 28 of 2021. Now Houston is at the 6 of Arizona. We've got a tight one there. Back to Jim and Phil.
Yeah, thank you, JB. We hear Andre Davis ran that kickback 63 yards to set up the Texans inside of 2 minutes to possibly go in and tie it again. Here come the Broncos to the line. 3:49 to go in a tie game. Moreno, the rookie, into the arms of Guyton, and a gain of two. Denver has three timeouts, or two timeouts, I beg your pardon. Here's a lineup tonight on CBS. It's all new, beginning with 60 Minutes. Amazing Race will follow, then Three Rivers and Cold Case only here on CBS, America's number one network. Out of the gun, Orton. Over to Gaffney, and the former Patriot is wrapped up. Will Hyde is hurt on the tackle. So an injury timeout. Broncos will be coming back facing third down. Orton has a career-high 30 completions. He's over 300 yards, but he faces now third and four.
The Patriots, the first two plays, definitely changed their defense, trying to be aggressive against the receivers at the line of scrimmage. Extra time, if Kyle Orton gets it, could get a wide open receiver.
And they pick up the first. Orton's going down the middle, and it's knocked away, incomplete. Sean Springs denied it. We're going for Gaffney.
Yeah, I tell you, that's a terrific play by Sean Springs, because they put him in motion and they create a little traffic jam. But he plays it inside, really, really well done. And everybody's going to, hey, had his arm on him. In the NFL, you can put your arm on the receiver as long as you don't turn him.
Brett Kern and Edelman awaits. This is not a very high kick. Edelman with a chance to run. He is wrapped up quickly by McBath, the rookie from Texas Tech, who they took in the second round. 44-yard punt, 7-yard return. We've had missed field goals on each side. Prater at the beginning of the game off the first drive was no good from 48. And Gostkowski almost grazed it, the upright, and missed from 40.
Two-minute warning coming. Patriots two timeouts, so all you're looking for is for a field goal try. Plenty of time.
Shakes off a tackle. Was going to go for it. No gain, but goes for 10 plus. He got away from Goodman. Picks up 18, in fact.
We've seen it on both sides today, where the defense is in position to make the tackles and stop the runs for no gain. Andre Goodman had him. Let him get outside.
We're at the 2-minute warning. Tied at 17. We're back with 2 minutes to go. Brady with his specialty right before him against a Denver defense has been quite the talk of the league the first month. Had given up only 26 points through 4 weeks. On first down, it's Morris. Ball is out. Ball is out. And a wild scramble for it. And New England maintains possession. That's Kazur with the recovery.
Football comes back. Comes back to where it was fumbled. Nick Kazur, wow, being alert. Well, you just, as coaches now, we see in this game, Jim, you've got to play and hold on. They're letting them go. So stripping of the football. Happening a lot more.
On second down, Brady. Ball knocked out. And at this time, the Broncos appear to have it. They do. Broncos set up at the New England 45. Bonnie Holiday was the one who knocked it out, and Elvis Dumervil recovers. Woodyard snatches that football right back from Vollmer, who had come out of the pile with it, and says, give it back. That ball belongs to us. That was Bonnie Holiday. First Denver sack of the day. Boy, is it a big one.
Yeah, you know what happens, Jim? Tom Brady stepped up in the pocket, and he stepped up so far, it allowed Bonnie Holiday to come underneath and get the sack and fumble. And Josh McDaniels not afraid to show his emotion on the sideline, is he?
Well, he has been ramped up in this half, rightfully so. Teams come back from 10 down. Now we'll have a chance to win it. Oh, hold on a minute. Ball's out again. And it was the rookie Moreno. They ruled him down at the 41. We saw him so cautiously holding on with two hands earlier in this quarter.
You know, that's a fumble. You know why it's a fumble? Even though he hits the ground, did he fall? Or the ground can cause a fumble. If you're not hit, the ground could cause a fumble, and you could review that.
We're inside 2 minutes, and no review coming from upstairs.
I couldn't see if New England recovered it.
Orton Over to Moreno. He is decked by Wilfork for a loss of three. Just like that, the New England defense stepping up, setting up a third down and long. Denver letting the clock run here. They have two timeouts. We understand that fumble, had it been ruled a fumble, in fact, was recovered by Clady, the left tackle of the Broncos anyway. So here they go with 22 seconds. And a timeout called by the New England side. Arizona, Houston, down to the wire. Let's go. And a little time for discussion over here. Houston, Arizona, with Arizona winning at 28-21. The goal line stand at the end by the Cardinals. The Texans had three plays from the one, and the Cardinals kept them out.
Well, Bill Belichick knows his timeouts are basically worthless now, so he uses them, as far as his offense is concerned, using them to go over the strategy one more time with his defense, what to look for and what to do in this situation. Do you blitz Kyle Orton, or do you play it safe and hope that you can make the tackle and still keep him out of field goal range? Looks like a short pass will be available.
Here comes the blitz. Orton in trouble. Just holds on to the football at midfield. What a stand by Banta Kane and Will Hyde, who was hurt earlier.
Oh, boy, Jim, I was going to say, New England needed to call timeout. Great timeout by Bill Belichick. The blitz, nobody's open immediately. You don't let Denver get one more throw.
Let's get an update out of New York. James Brown.
Jim, as you mentioned, three plays from the one did Houston have. This is fourth and one, fourth and goal from the one. Chris Brown right in the middle of the pile, no go. Arizona's D holds up, and Arizona escapes 28-21 over Houston. Back to Jim and Phil.
There was a booth review there to see if he crossed the plane. The call on the field upheld, and the Cardinals win it. Now, that timeout you were saying was so crucial by Bill Belichick.
Yes, you can't let the clock keep moving. Then Josh McDaniels would have called a timeout with 4 seconds and got one more throw into the end zone. So Bill Belichick, very aware of that, calls the timeout, makes Denver keep on playing.
15 seconds to go in regulation. And it's down at the 5. But nothing fancy coming up from New England, no doubt. We're going to have an overtime game here.
How about that finish, though? Just the way it's going, the football hitting the ground.
Well, for those just joining us, that Arizona-Houston audience coming in, this was a first half that New England controlled, leading 17-7, a couple of Brady touchdown passes, but they've been shut out in the second half.
No Denver defense showing their versatility and speed, and that's really what causes so many. That's what's caused problems for all five football teams so far this year.
Well, we had one overtime game earlier today, and that was Dallas winning at Kansas City on a touchdown pass from Romo to Miles Austin, who had a huge day. Over 200 yards and a couple of touchdowns. And again, 60 minutes, Amazing Race, Three Rivers, and Cold Case coming up tonight here on America's number one network. They're coming out for the coin toss. One 15-minute period, two timeouts given to each team. No coaches' challenges, booth reviews only. First team to score will win it. Denver will try to improve its record to 5-0, while New England where the win would go to 4-1. And of course, this Denver story, no one saw this kind of success coming in Josh McDaniels' rookie season as a head coach.
Well, his organizational skills and bringing in the free agents and the draft.
An overtime period of up to 15 minutes. The first team that scores wins. If the game ends in a tie, it remains in a tie. Each team gets two timeouts. There's fourth quarter timing rules. All of the reviews will be handled up in the replay booth. Each team gets two timeouts. That's heads. That's tails. New England gets to call the toss. He calls tails. It is heads.
Well, the Broncos will have the football when overtime commences in a moment. Jim Nantz and Phil Sims back here at Invesco Field at Mile High in a 17-17 game through four quarters. Kyle Orton will be coming out. He'll get the football first. He earlier today threw his only interception of the season. It was on a Hail Mary throw to close out the first half and was picked by, of all people, Randy Moss. It's the only miscue of the season. And Gostkowski, when he's been kicking in this direction today, he's done so twice. They have not been returned. Once, in fact, he flew it through the back of the end zone. This one also. All the way and beyond. Orton, you know, for a guy that was so maybe overshadowed by the fact that Cutler was going to Chicago. By the way, they've never met, he said. He told us he's never had a chance to even say hello to him. He has a remarkable record at home in his career as a starter. He's 17-2 with what he's done here at Denver, and back in his days at Denver at home as a starter. He's going to start out the overtime, out of the gun, step up and fling it to Marshall. And that ball batted around, and Sean Springs is certain that New England has it. The official looks like he's marking it for Denver at the 31. A catch for Denver it is. Goes for 11 yards.
Brandon Marshall coming down the field, hooking up inside. And you know it's a catch because there's McGowan doesn't even really get up and argue the point.
Now Orton over to Scheffler, and two good pass plays to start the overtime. This one's good for 7.
Little different scenario right here. The New England Patriots had success at the end of the game because they knew there was no second chances. So they came up and they started blitzing and they started playing very tight coverage on the receivers. Here in overtime, since the Broncos are backed up, they backed off. McCoward hits the first two passes.
On the second down and 3. Back over to Eddie Royal for another first down. 3 plays, 3 completions, and a couple of firsts.
Yeah, there's a blitz. Another good throw, outside and low. Very accurate and very safe. Ooh, there was a blitzer coming free. Good thing they had a quick throw on.
Prater, and I told you earlier that he has a long-range lead. He's made 6 out of 7. In his career from 50 and beyond. Although he did miss earlier today from 48. Timeout New England, one of their 2.
Could line up again.
Yep. So timeout, less than 2 minutes into overtime here at Denver.
Now, more than ever, you want to keep your loved ones safe and secure. Give them the gift of financial security from New York Life. We've been protecting families for over 164 years. New York Life, the company you keep.
Thanks to our everyday low prices, Halloween costs less at Walmart. Save money, live better, Walmart.
on CBS. It all begins with 60 Minutes, a report on the most dangerous sport of all, cliff diving and flying, if you will. The Amazing Race, Three Rivers, Cold Case, tonight on America's number one network. We will come out of the New England timeout. Moreno, and O'Shawn takes it to the New England side of the field at the 48.
I tell you, just a good quick snap count by Kyle Orton. They've really kept this New England defense off balance all day long with their Wild Horses offense. The quick snap there and their array of plays. And when's the last time you saw the Patriots have to call so many timeouts because they couldn't get lined up properly?
Moreno, who told us he doesn't watch a lot of football, never been a real football watcher. I think even he would be sitting home watching this if he wasn't playing it. And he gets the carry. It's stacked up on second down and short.
Tough,
no gain.
Tough defense to run against. And that look, Patriots playing run the whole way. We said it earlier. Don't run a Vince Wilfork in these situations.
And about a half yard shy. So a big third and one.
I say they throw it here. And if they don't make it, I think they'll go for it on fourth down.
They are going to throw for it, Phil. And Royal has it at the New England 40. What tipped you off about a throw there?
Well, because how many times have we seen them run it on third down and lose yardage? But they put all the receivers to one side. What a job by Eddie Royal. Fake to the outside and then swats. The defender, it comes inside.
Eddie Royal.
Sean Springs, no chance.
Royal had eight catches on the year through four games. He's got 10 today. From the 40 to Moreno. Moreno in the field goal range at the 29. Daniel Graham helped seal that side, and it gains 11.
Again, so quick to the outside. How about Daniel Graham on his block? He put the defense in a position where Brandon Merriweather was the only one that could stop the run. He's running too fast. Good job by Moreno, cutting it back.
Jordan is the running back here. Lamont Jordan holds on with two hands to the 27.
They're in field goal range, of course. We see here in Denver, this is like playing in the dome. It's 10 extra yards for kickers. Boy, and after that last block, Daniel Graham, an ex-Patriot, he turned to the Patriot sideline, and I'm sure he let him know what he thinks.
Second down and eight. Orton's going for the big one. Oh, and is this going to draw a flag? No. Eddie Royal, legs were tangled for a moment with Sean Springs.
Well, you said the proper word. Legs tangled means no foul.
Receiver's feet tangled with the defender. By rule, that is no defensive pass interference. Third down.
Third down coming up.
Oh, that was a good call.
And they want to kick it here on third down. Timeout called by Denver. This would be a 45-yard field goal from here if they elect to go ahead and boot it, but
if Eddie Royal was stayed outside, Jim, I'm sorry. If he could stayed outside, it's going to be a touchdown.
It'd be about a 45-yard field goal from here if they elect to go for it or fail to get any yardage on third down. And, of course, they had that opening win, the miracle finish, the deflection of the Stokely touchdown with seconds to go. Last week, Brandon Marshall zigzagging through the Cowboys into the breakup at the end by Champ Bailey. They're going to keep the offensive unit out there. Yes, the last time they started undefeated, Mike Shanahan.
They know,
the Broncos went on to win the Super Bowl. At 5-0, that is.
The pass protection has been so good today. I think you go back and you give your receivers one more chance to make the play and make the field goal attempt much easier. Everybody at the line of scrimmage.
And no flag here, going for Marshall. So this will call on Matt Prater. And a 45-yard try. Now, let's see. There is a flag at the back end of this.
Offsides defense.
Zone. 5-yard penalty. Replay, third down.
Boy, no one even on the Denver bench saw it. They already had Prater and the whole field goal unit team out there. So that moves it 5 yards closer, and they'll get to replay third down.
So the Patriots.
Looks like Bannacane is lined up offside.
Absolutely. You're right, it is Bannacane. Everybody up at the line of scrimmage for this New England defense. The safe play is throw long.
Going for Marshall one more time. He tried to reach around. He was really well guarded by Springs. And now it'll come down to the kick. That is defending your man right there. So a former Patriot who was part of all those Super Bowl wins, Lonnie Paxton, came over with McDaniels. He'll snap it back to Brett Kern, and Matt Prater will try to be the hero from 40. Actually call it 41. And Belichick's called timeout. Tom Brady in his overtime career, regular season and postseason, 7-0. Never lost in overtime, but he could lose today and never touch the football. Now Prater, who was originally signed by Detroit as a free agent out of Central Florida, has a chance to win it from 41 yards. The two that met in the first ever AFL game, commemorating that occasion with the throwback uniforms today. A game won by Denver by three back then in 1960. Trying to win it right here by three. Prater, Kern gets it down. The kick is on the way, and the Broncos are 5-0. Here's the handshake between Belichick, the guru, and his young pupil. They're looking for one another. Couldn't find each other. There is great respect between these two. No issues at all. We talked to McDaniels and Belichick about what it'll be like at the end. And even McDaniels had to say that it would be a handshake, one with great respect. That would define our relationship, what it truly is. A lot of the old assistants, though, as Belichick still searches for McDaniels. Thirteen unanswered points after halftime. Boy, is there some energy in this stadium and in this city now.
Not afraid to show his emotions, and I'll tell you, it carries over when you watch the football team play, Jim. I thought the Broncos all day long, on both sides of the football, emotion, never gave in, even when it was down, and it just outlasted the New England Patriots.
You saw number 90 of the Broncos lift him in the air on a hug. That was Kenny Peterson, who played for his father, Tom McDaniels, at Canton McKinley High School. So Peterson plays for the father and plays for the son. And Denver is now 5-0.
It's a way to celebrate a win. You know what? We saw it on Friday, how long they practiced, how much they worked, and they all admitted it's something special to go against the Patriots.
There's the Prater boot. Never in doubt. 5-0 with four come-from-behind victories. And you told me, even beginning a couple of weeks ago before we saw them in person, you felt just what people were saying around the league, they were the real deal. 20-17, Denver wins it in overtime. Coming up next, 60 minutes, Amazing Race, Three Rivers, and Cold Case. For Phil Sims, this is Jim Nantz saying so long from Denver. You've been watching the NFL on CBS, home of Super Bowl 44.